Today's topic is treatment approach to a large periapical lesion. My meaning here by large periapical lesion is whenever you come across a periapical lesion and the size of the lesion creates a doubt in your mind about the treatment approach of the case is the large periapical lesion. It usually happens when the diameter of lesion is more than 10 mm. There are variety of case reports and case series in literature which conclude that size of the lesion doesn't matter and periapical lesion of any size can be healed by non-surgical RCT. But when it comes to our clinics, many times we stuck because of size of periapical lesion. There can be many reasons to this. Sometimes patient demand treatment plan and cost before you start the procedure. Sometimes the dilemma is when to switch from non-surgical to surgical endodontics. And sometimes we think RCT of a related tooth may not be required because it can be a non-odontogenic lesion. So before progressing to diagnosis and treatment plan, take a careful case history, clinical examination and radiographs like OPG to rule out any syndrome or non-odontogenic lesions. There can be multiple lesions in relation to non-carious teeth indicative of non-odontogenic origin, or sometimes location of lesion also hint about the type of developmental cyst. Next step is to check vitality. If the tooth is non-vital and associated with carious teeth or history of trauma in related region, the chances of having a periapical granuloma or cyst are high. But if teeth are non-vital and there are no caries and no history of trauma, then we have to be careful as this can happen because of pressure created by non-odontologic lesions. If associated teeth are vital, then there is no doubt that the lesion is not associated with teeth and you must take an opinion of oral surgeon or OMR specialist. Some of the tumors like ameloblastoma are very aggressive and if you delay in diagnosis, it can lead to a lot of damage. Now coming to periapical cyst or granuloma. Once you rule out all the non-odontogenic lesions, ensure that it is related to tooth, then only dilemma is to treat it surgically or non-surgically. Here you have to note some points. First is presence of intraoral sinus. You can treat it with conventional RCT. Sinus is usually associated with periapical abscesses and they can be treated non-surgically. Then palpate the periapical lesion and check the intraoral periapical radiograph. If it indicates that there is loss of both buccal and palatal or lingual bony plates, then the treatment will require many sitting if you do non-surgical treatment. But periapical surgery can give you quick response in such cases. When you start with root canal access and there is some drainage from the canal, if it looks like a cystic fluid that is quite different from pus, you can easily differentiate. It indicates that there is a pocket cyst and it can heal with non-surgical endodontics but needs a lot of patience and expertise along with many settings. In such cases, better to go for a surgical treatment. The last scenario is you completed the RCT, there was no drainage, canals were dry during the treatment, but periapical lesion is not healing on follow-ups. Or you can say after the BMP, canals are dry but swelling is there. This indicates presence of a true periapical cyst and it needs surgical excision. Thank you.